I like them too. But if you can't code and eventually not be able to fill some of the coding jobs, then games will be not better, but more like a thumbs down. Also, adults need coding because they need certain programs to manage their money and do other things. Coding is important to many people, even people who are behind in learning. Those apps or websites that they use improve how much they know. And with no coding, computers would basically be useless. Coding runs far down in the line. It starts from binary, the computer-generated code. Then it goes another step higher to a code that codes some of the main languages, like JavaScript. And then after that comes some of the main coding languages, like Python, JavaScript, and much more. According to Stephen Hawking, theoretical physicist, cosmologist, and author, whether you want to uncover the secrets of the universe or you want to pursue a career in the 21st century, basic computer programming is an essential skill to learn. Also, Steve Jobs, former owner of Apple, said, "Everybody in this country should learn how to program a computer because it teaches you how to think." If these people have wonderful careers, and in their quotes they recommended coding, there's no doubt we should try coding too. And even if you want to be an astronaut or an author, whatever you want to be, you should learn how to code too. These days, although most elementary schools, 90%, don't teach coding, coding is probably more important than reading or even writing. I encourage all of you to start coding and help improve the world, because all it takes is inspiration. And that's it.
Hi, my name is Andrew Marcus. Today, I'm here to talk to you about achieving goals. To be honest with you, life is about powering through obstacles by finding solutions. One person that had to overcome very challenging problems was Walt Disney, but he got through them by setting big goals and achieving them. Walter Elias Disney was born in Chicago, Illinois in 1901. The Disney family soon moved to a farm in Missouri. There, Walt developed a love for animals. After the farm failed, the family moved to Kansas City. Even in the beginning, Walt had faced challenges like the farm failing. You may think they hated this, but that's not the case. Walt learned to find the positives and ignore the negatives. This was the first goal that he accomplished. In 1919, he worked as a commercial illustrator. By 1922, Walt had his own shop. The business failed, though, and Walt went to Hollywood, California in 1923. There, he began producing Oswald the Rabbit cartoons for Universal Studios. Even though Walt's first business failed, he still got up on his feet. That is what I call a true hero. Since the job at Universal didn't work out, Walt decided to come up with his own character. Steamboat Willie was his first success. The character was first called Mortimer Mouse, but his wife told him to change the name to Mickey Mouse. Walt reinvested all of his profits toward improving his pictures. The Disney shorts of the 1930s were successful all over the world. Again, Walt got knocked back down but got right up. He learned from his mistakes and made the business even better than last time. This is truly incredible. On July 18, 1957, Walt opened Disneyland in Anaheim, California. As I look at this information, I believe anything is possible. Walt turned his little shop into an empire. This takes a lot of time and effort, but it's all worth it. It's worth seeing a seed blossom into a flower. It's worth seeing a baby grow into an adult. It's worth seeing your life build its own path. Furthermore, Walt created and funded the California Institute of the Arts. He wanted people to dream and develop. Walt Disney died in 1966 in Los Angeles, California. At the time of his death, his enterprises brought him respect and admiration. Walt Disney had great imagination and creativity. He did things that no one dreamt was possible. This is what made him so special. Every time I go to Disney World, I gaze upon the statue of the man who brought so much happiness to my life. When I look into that statue's eyes, I see hope that anything is possible. The only words that form into my mind are believe and create. My body is filled with joy, and I can't contain my excitement any longer. The one phrase I always whispered to myself is, it all started with a mouse. So please, all I ask of you today is to set a goal and achieve it. You can do it. Thank you.
biking, walking, and carpooling. The reason I'm bringing this to your attention is that over half of our air pollution comes from cars. 70% of our air pollution comes from cars. That's a lot. You can help prevent most of our air pollution by riding bikes, walking, carpooling, bus, and so much more. You can also, if you're walking or biking, get exercise. Now, biking to where you're going is great exercise and gets you out of traffic. I know I would like that. Biking is also a quick way to get places. You can also hang out with your friends while riding a bike. Walking is another quick and easy way of getting around. Walking is also exercise. Walking, as well as biking, gets you out of traffic. In conclusion, I feel as if we should all have at least 1 week in the month that we don't take a car to where we are going. We could, for example, take a bus to a local event. We could walk to the park or ride your bike. You could purchase an electric car, even though it doesn't get you out of traffic. It doesn't create exhaust. We need to lower the percentage of air pollution from cars. We can do this together. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Leon. Today I'm going to be talking about bullying, the truth behind it. Did you know many people bully because of low self-esteem? Actually, not just that. In fact, many people make the decision to participate in bullying behavior because they enjoy power over other people. Bullies sometimes think if others were as miserable as he or she is, it will make him or her happier. Bullies usually like to bully in front of other people. They think it will make him or her look cooler. That doesn't look cool at all. Bullying is very hurtful to other people. Did you know there's a lot of bystanders and most likely one upstander? Having just one upstander can change a bully's life. Gossiping about someone and name-calling is an example of bullying. Over 3.2 million students are victims of bullying each year. Approximately 160,000 students are victims and skip school because of bullying. 72% of American students report being bullied 2 to 3 times a month or more within a school semester. When you see bullying, there are safe things you can do to make it stop. If you feel like bullying, go do something else, like play a video game, watch TV, or talk to a friend or adult you trust. Keep in mind, everyone is different, not better or worse, just different, which makes them unique. If you think you bullied someone in the past, go apologize and you have solved what you think you have done wrong. I'm going to be an upstander, not a bystander. I can encourage others to be an upstander, not a bystander, by making them realize helping people is a really good thing. Becoming a bystander is not good because it does not make people feel good on the inside, and the victim has to worry about something they shouldn't have to worry about. So being an upstander is a great choice in life. Thank you.
I'm in fifth grade, and I am 10 years old. Today I came here to talk to you about what is happening to the bees. How would you feel if I told you that if bees were to go extinct, we wouldn't be able to eat foods like almonds, apples, oranges, and many other things too? Bees are disappearing in large numbers. Whole colonies are dying off fast. It is because of many different reasons. This environmental problem is very serious and important because bees pollinate the crops that provide about 90% of all our food source. One of the main reasons for the decrease in bee population is colony collapse disorder, otherwise known as CCD. CCD is caused by chemical use in bee colonies, chemical toxins in the environment, and genetically modified crops. When a colony of CCD starts to collapse, it doesn't have enough adult bees to support the amount of brood, egg and larva, in the colony. Another reason bees are disappearing is because farmers are putting special insecticides called neonics on their crops, and it is killing off the bees. When seeds have neonics on them and they are planted, the chemicals get into the nectar and pollen, so when the bees pollinate, they get sick and die. The reason the neonics are so deadly to bees is because they are 6,000 times more toxic than regular insecticides. You would think that people would be trying to help save the bees from these chemicals, but some big chemical companies are asking to use up to 400 times more of these types of chemicals than usually allowed. In 2013, Dave Shute, a farmer, lost 37 million of his bees due to the use of neonics. This was an unexpected turn in of events, which devastates his crop production. A third reason bees are dying off is because of global warming. As the climate changes, the flowers are blooming at different times, which also affects the time that the bees pollinate. According to beependent.wordpress.com, climate change is affecting pollination by disrupting the synchronized timing of flower blooming and the timing at which bees pollinate. Flowers are blooming earlier in the growing season due to rising temperatures, before many bees have a chance of pollinating the plants. This shows that because of global warming, flowers are blooming early, so bees don't have a chance to collect the nectar from those flowers for a food source. One last reason that bee population is decreasing is because of habitat loss. According to beependent.wordpress.com, urbanization not directly removes bee habitat and isolates the land in which bees are trying to travel across. This is very effective because it decreases the amount of land they are able to pollinate in. If we don't try our best to help save the bees now, pretty soon it'll be too late to try anything. The simple explanation is this. Without bees to pollinate our crops, we have no food. Some of the ways you can help are to plant native wildflowers and don't use any chemicals on them. You can also eat organic foods, because organic companies don't use pesticides or chemicals on their crops. Go online or to your local library to find out more ways on how you can help save the bees. Thank you. And I also want to say thank you to all my peers, my teacher, my parents, and all my friends. And I want to say happy birthday to my mom, too.
Hi, my name is Vincent LaFault, and today I will be speaking about changing schools. At my first school, I was a Shaker Road Heron. At my second school, I went to Catholic school. At my third school, I was a Western Whirlwind. And now I am a Pine View Patriot. I have had many experiences, like my favorite teachers, usually gym in my homeroom. I've also had lots of friends, one that I still talk to from Shaker Road about once a week on FaceTime. And I've also had lots of memories like the Weston Kickball League. The problem is you have to leave all your friends, and then you have to worry about, are you going to be lonely and bullied, or are you going to be the coolest kid in the school and have tons of friends? You also worry about your teachers, because you don't want a teacher that doesn't teach you anything, and you don't want a teacher that is just mean. The academics are also different, because if you didn't learn double-digit multiplication, and they did, you have to learn that quick so you can catch on with everything. You also bullying. I hate this topic. As a new kid for the last two schools, I have dealt with bullies both years. As a new kid, you get bullied because you don't have as many friends. That is a big problem. As I build relationships and get friends, they help with the bullying, but the bullying never stops. The bullies do these little attacks that build up over time. And when I tell an adult, the bully knows, and the attacks get worse. What could teachers do for new students to help new students like me get fit in? Assign a nice buddy to guide me through the first week. It's really helpful. Put me at a table with a lot of friends. This is very important because it can help with the bullying because you have more friends. Can we play some getting to know you games like Lightning Round? Lightning Round is a game where your teacher gives you a topic and you go around in a circle and you say your favorite thing, like maybe the topic's food and chicken. Check in with me. Every week, your teacher should check in with you because if you're having a bully, you need to tell your teacher immediately. And if you're having problems with kids at your table or you're having problems with the academics, simple things like that. Changing schools may not be easy, but it can certainly be a blast.
Have you ever tried to walk into a store, but someone's smoking right next to the door? It just gets you so sick. Why do people smoke if it only causes lung cancer and diseases to your body? Millions of people die every day because because they used to smoke or because they're still smoking, and that bothers me. You should be using your money for something useful, like clothes, food, water, and shelter. When someone smokes around you, it causes secondhand smoke. Secondhand smoke can harm you just as much as a cigarette can. According to kidshealth.org, smoking gives kids bad breath, yellow teeth, smelly clothes, warm colds and coughs, and difficulty playing sports with friends. Cigarettes and tobacco may cost a lot of money, but for heavy smokers, they waste at least $1,000 a year on cigarettes. And for light smokers, they waste $338. That's a lot of money. And trust me, I wouldn't want to be one of the ones wasting all my money on that. My grandfather smokes, and I'm afraid he's going to get lung cancer. But together, we can save millions of people by not smoking. Also, according to heart.org, the website states that the toxic chemicals in cigarettes and tobacco can destroy your body over time, especially your heart and your lungs. By telling me this, I know that the right choice is to stop smoking. You should be saving yourself and helping yourself by not smoking. If someone asks you if you want a cigarette, just say no. It's simple. You don't always get lung cancer, but you do get super, super sick. There are some college kids that are already smoking, and that's not good. Please do me a good favor, a big favor, a tremendous favor, and don't smoke.
I am here to tell you about Cesar Chavez. He was a very important man in the vibrant labor movement. He used nonviolence in order to get what is right. The purpose I am here is because nonviolence is... You can use nonviolence in order to get what is right. The purpose I am here is because nonviolence is a peaceful way to help fight for what you believe in and is kind of help people. He ran into many problems and he got frustrated, but he never got violent. When he was a kid, he went through many struggles. They had to sell their farm and store. After they sold their land, they lived in the poor part of town. When he finished eighth grade, he dropped out of school so he could help his family on the farm and because his family could not afford high school. When he grew up, he got married to a lady named Helen. She and Caesar helped farmers get paid more and also stopped them from using pesticides. Because he did not believe in violence, Chavez had a fast for 25 days and 36 days. During his fast, he was very weak, but it made people want to side with him and another, and because he wasn't eating, and people wanted to help him and his cause. He walked over 300 miles for a strike. At the end, it was all worth it. He made harmful pesticides illegal, and he also helped farm workers get paid more. Cesar Chavez was a very important man. I chose him because he believed in nonviolent ways of solving problems, and he stood up for what he truly believed in. Even though fasting was not easy, he died on April 23, 1993, of natural causes at the age of 66. He made a difference. There were streets named after him, and there's a holiday for him. And people who worked in the farm industry remember what he did. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Emma. Today I'll be talking about animal cruelty, also known as animal abuse. Animal cruelty is when someone does not care or hurts an animal in any way. For example, this picture shows a dog that has been starved. Apparently his owners did not want to feed him or just didn't have time to feed him. Now, I have a question. Many of you are probably animal lovers. Well, I know I am. But seriously, who would want to hurt these innocent, beautiful creatures? First of all, it's against the law to hurt animals. And second of all, well, animals are just like us. They need everything we need. So why don't you think for a second? Would you really want to be this animal, and would you really want to be put in the situation of being abused? No, so don't do it to animals. If you abuse animals, sometimes it'll go unrecognized, but sometimes it won't, and sometimes it'll go in the daily newspaper, on TV, and even on the internet. So whenever you see an animal being abused, please promise me something. Go and help that animal by calling the police or animal control. But you should never go face-to-face with an animal because it might be so afraid of humans and it might fight back.
For example, this is a male dog that has been badly abused. The animal rescue team has been trying to save this dog for quite a while now, but as I said before, this animal is really scared of humans, so he keeps on running away, and he will not let them save him. And they predict that he got into a fight because, as you can see, his left eye is gone. Also, people use animals for human entertainment. In SeaWorld, they use dolphins and killer whales for our enjoyment. I know I don't enjoy that. This picture shows a steer being abused in a rodeo, which is a form of human entertainment. And this picture shows a baby elephant being forced to train for the circus. As you can see, none of these animals want to be doing this. They are kidnapped, but as I call it, animal-napped, from their home, and they will never see their family and friends ever again. This is what they do before the show starts. They beat these animals to their death. And this picture just caught my eye. This shows a homeless dog on the street, and as you can see, it's been through a lot of abuse. So please, please help these animals. We can do it together by rescuing one from an animal shelter. They are waiting for you to adopt them. I know that because I have a 3-year-old puppy named Rocco, and we rescued him, and he was the last dog there. Not only was he the last dog there, but he just caught my eye, and we rescued him before he got put down. So rescue him today. You will really make